दिस इज एच सी वर्मा चैप्टर नंबर 26 क्वेश्चन नंबर 19. इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन बिकॉज दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम वी आर अप्लाइंग फर्स्ट लॉ फॉर अ लिक्विड. टिल नाउ वी हैव बीन अप्लाइंग द फर्स्ट लॉ ओनली फॉर गैसेस एंड वी वर सेइंग दैट क्यू इक्वल टू डेल्टा यू प्लस डब्ल्यू काइंड ऑफ थिंग. ऑल्सो इन द क्लास वी मेड अ नोट दैट लिक्विड्स एक्सपैंड बाय अ वेरी लिटिल अमाउंट. वी डू नेग्लेक्ट द इंक्रीज इन वॉल्यूम एंड वी से दैट इट्स ऑलमोस्ट लाइक अ कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम प्रोसेस. हाउएवर इन दिस क्वेश्चन यू कैन सी दैट the change in internal energy we have to calculate when the water is getting heated from 0 degree to 4 degree, and it is also given that there is a slight difference in the density values. Although negligible, we have to take it into account, like 999.9 to 1000 kind of thing. So let's say we have a liquid, or for that matter any solid is also fine. We were discussing in the class that they expand by a very little amount. We were neglecting that, not anymore now. Okay, so let's say because of heating there is a little bit of increase in volume. So what are they doing? Well, they are expanding here, this liquids or this solid, anything is fine here. Now there is a atmosphere surrounding them, so here this dot dot are representing the atmospheric gas molecules, and these atmospheric gas molecules were completely there, like throughout the or surroundings. What the solid is doing or this liquid is doing is it is expanding. So it is occupying this volume for itself, which was previously occupied by the atmospheric gas. So this green portion is the extra volume which is generated right now due to expansion, which was previously occupied by the atmospheric molecules. Now when this solid is expanding, this solid is expanding against the atmospheric pressure, because this atmospheric pressure here is trying to oppose this expansion by applying a force pressure into area kind of thing. And so this is the work done by this solid to push the atmosphere out and occupy the volume for itself. And we have already calculated the work done against the atmosphere to be equal to P naught into delta V. So this kind of heating of a solid is actually a constant pressure process, actually, because the surrounding pressure is same constant throughout the process, which is P naught. But this constant pressure process is almost also equal to like 99.99% equal to constant volume process. And that's why we were saying that constant pressure and constant volume for liquids and gases are almost, sorry, for liquids and solids are almost same. But here we have to take into account that slight change in volume and not treat this process as a constant volume process, but treat it as a constant pressure one. So here anyway, Q is equal to delta U plus W, and Q is the heat supplied, and heat supplied to raise the temperature. So NC delta T is equal to delta U plus P delta V. Now the specific heat capacity is already given, but not given per mole, but it's given per unit mass. This specific heat capacity is related to always the heat part and not the change in internal energy part. Specific heat is defined as the amount of heat given to the solid to increase its temperature by some degree centigrade, and what the solid does with that heat is altogether a different matter. Here the solid will expand also a little bit, so a portion of the heat supplied will go into expansion also. Actually here the thing is the water behaves very anomalously between 0 and 4 degree centigrade, and it actually contracts on heating. Anyways, so what is the specific heat given? 4200. The delta T is 4 minus 0. The mass of the water which is given here is 2 kg. We have to find out how much is the increase in internal energy. P naught is 10 raised to 5. Delta V. Delta V is the, actually this is delta V. Delta V is the change in volume. Final volume minus initial volume. Mass is 2 divided by final density. Final density is 1000. Density at 0 and 4. 0 means 999.9. Okay. Okay, here I think density at 0 degree is given as 999.9, and upon heating its density is increasing. Yeah. So 1000 minus 2 by 999.9. So mass by density gives us the volume, final minus initial. So using this, you will be able to calculate the delta U value. So I hope you have understood this question number 19 from SA Verma chapter number 26.